I don't know if he is going to get everyday starts, but I do anticipate him getting a good amount of starts at second base. Could see him as a platoon option with Adam Frazier, which, by the way, is a little bit weird because Jordan Westburg this year has had some pretty crazy reverse splits. Yeah. He's been much better against right-handed pitching than left-handed pitching this year at AAA Norfolk. I don't know how much the Orioles are really going to be paying attention to that. I would assume that they just probably think that those splits will go back to where we are used to seeing right-handed hitters. But as of right now, I would kind of expect a platoon with Adam Frazier, with maybe Jordan Westburg getting a little bit more of the nod if it's a toss-up between the two.
Yeah, and it's all dependent on how he plays, right? I mean, if this kid comes out of nowhere and skyrockets and is just, you know, hitting the cover off the ball, obviously he's going to see more playing time. But realistically, I think you're right about a platoon with Frazier on the right side of the infield. But the thing is, this kid can play anywhere in the infield, really.
Right.
He could play second base. He could play left side. I saw some people saying they might see him potentially playing some shortstop this year. So he has the ability to go anywhere, and I think that's what you have. That's the positive aspect of him, is that he's so versatile, and he's that utility guy within the infield and also has a good bat.
Yeah, so when you look at the infield at this point, Jorge Mateo has been struggling offensively, but is still an excellent defensive shortstop. He is still valuable in the lineup day in and day out. It's just really a matter of whether or not you can keep the bat in there if the cold stretch continues. But obviously, we anticipate Jorge Mateo being able to get back a little bit closer to form to where he was at the beginning of the season. Adam Frazier is still playing solid baseball, albeit the on-base percentage probably not where you would hope.
OPS below, but 700.
Right. He's still one of the better defensive second basemen. He has come up in a lot of clutch situations. He still, I think, has around one war, according to Baseball Reference. Jorge Mateo right around there as well. And then Ramon Arias, I mean, ever since that Brewers series where he had three hits, I think in game two of that series, you know, against his brother, he's been hitting around 300 since that stretch. So Ramon Arias has been looking a lot better at the plate. We know what he can do defensively. He's a gold glove third baseman. And of course, Gunnar Henderson has been on a heater for the last month or so. He is a quality defensive shortstop, an excellent defensive third baseman. So the Orioles have a lot of options in the middle infield, and I think it's really just going to come down to matchups. I mean, we've seen Jordan Westburg in the lineup against two left-handed pitchers. I would anticipate Adam Frazier still getting some run against right-handed pitchers, but you could have Westburg in there at shortstop. You could have him at third. I think he's going to be mostly second baseman, but you could move Arias to third and first. You could move Gunnar to shortstop and third base. I mean, heck, even Jorge Mateo could play the outfield if you needed him to. So the Orioles have a lot of options with what to do with these shortstops.
Yeah, and I'm just thinking down the road as well, if he continues to put up good numbers and he continues to have a solid campaign, when you come around playoff time and you have a guy like that that you can bring off the bench and you can put fresh legs out there,
yeah,
that's a solid player and could start on other teams, that's so helpful. And that's something that's going to help you beat other teams when it matters most. So Westburg, I think, could be hugely, hugely helpful and important to an Orioles playoff run, too.
Yeah, and that's true of really anybody in this infield that could potentially move to more of a bench role. I mean, if Jorge Mateo turns into a kind of defensive replacement pinch runner type of player, I mean,
he's
that's
the best one in the majors. That's
he's the best one in the majors. I mean, if Adam Frazier turns into a bench piece, he is an incredibly valuable veteran who can come in and give you and a lefty bat who can give you good at bats against right-handed pitching and solid defense at second base. I mean, Ramon Arias would be the best defensive replacement in all of baseball. So really any of these guys, if they turn into quote-unquote bench pieces, which I don't really think any of them will, but if any of them did, they're like the best bench pieces in the league at that point.
Yeah, the O's are set up for success, and that's what having that surplus of talent in the minors does for you. When you can bring up guys, and again, they still have plenty of talent down there that they haven't tapped into that we'll get into. So that's what it gets you. It gets you so much talent around the infield, and you can bring in guys like that, and they can end up being starters for you. It changes the entire complexity of your team.
But again, this decision to call up Jordan Westburg came down to the fact that, yes, he proved everything he needed to prove at AAA Norfolk, but he also showed that he is at least a part of the conversation for the best options that are going to win you the most games in the infield at the big league level. It's not just about Jordan Westburg's development. The Orioles are firmly in the playoff hunt at this point. So it is about making sure that you have the players on your roster who give you the best chance to win games. I know there's going to be a lot of conversation about Colton Cowser, but it's kind of the same sort of conversation with Jordan Westburg. If you're looking solely at Colton Cowser's development, then yes, maybe he has proved everything he needs to prove at AAA Norfolk, and he should be at the big league level, and that's what would be best for his development. If you were finding everyday at-bats for him in the majors, that's what Colton Cowser could be doing right now. But you have Austin Hayes playing all-star level baseball. Cedric Mullins, just back from injury, was playing all-star level baseball. Anthony Santander is a fixture in the middle of the lineup, and Aaron Hicks has been pretty unbelievable since the Orioles got him in free. So the question there becomes, where would you put Colton Cowser? Because, you know, we've heard arguments of, you know, maybe he would take Ryan McKenna's spot at the big league level, but Ryan McKenna isn't getting everyday at-bats. Ryan McKenna is filling the role that he needs to fill at the big league level really well, which is he is a good defensive replacement, and he can give you some quality at-bats against left-handed pitching. Ryan McKenna has been exactly what the Orioles need him to be. And Colton Cowser probably isn't going to come up to the majors and fill the same role as Ryan McKenna would fill.
Yeah, the difference there is that you know what McKenna is going to give you.
Yeah.
While Cowser, of course, has such a high ceiling, you don't know what that floor is at the major league level right now.
Sure.
But what I want to say is what the Orioles have built here is a situation in which you don't have to go into the deadline looking for a bat, like a lot of other teams have to. A lot of other championship contending teams have to and have done in the past. You have plenty of guys you can bring up and just say, let's try this one. Let's try this one. Isn't that such an what a niche thing that pretty much only the Orioles have the luxury of doing is, all right, we need a bat. Let's bring up Colton Cowser, see what he can do. And maybe he'll just be on fire for a month. And he's the guy that's going to be that fixture in the lineup instead of having to go out and go get somebody from another team or have to make a deal for somebody. And then they have the kind of double-edged sword there where they have so much ammo and a surplus of minor league talent that if they had to, they could.